really want to cover the topic of mental health. Mental health awareness, why it is so important to listen to your body, listen to your mind, and become aware of mental health, self-care, self-love, all of those things that tie into making up our mental. It's fun until it gets to the mental. So you guys, I want to jump right into it because a lot of us, especially with the global pandemic for almost 2 years, we are really, really, really suffering with mental health awareness, really giving it the credit that it needs, giving it the resources that it needs. And you guys, we all at some point are going to have some anxiety, have some depression, have some, I don't know, just something that is keeping us from being our fullest 100%, our fullest self. And so you guys, I have a couple steps that can help heighten your mental health awareness. If we are not properly taking care of ourselves, we know that our mental will suffer, which could cause insanity. So I'm gonna jump right into it. The first thing is being honest with yourself. If you are literally a jittery, happy person and times are changing that, if you are really, really struggling to get out the bed, if you are having more panic attacks and it feels like you're having a heart attack and you can't identify what's going on in your body, your mental is telling you, hey, I am overwhelmed. I need to go outside and, you know, have a change of scenery. I need to exercise. I need something that is out of what this norm is. And so just being honest with yourself, just knowing that, hey, I haven't been feeling like myself for weeks or months or maybe even this whole year and a half during this pandemic. So that is the first thing, being honest with yourself. And two, identifying your symptoms, feelings, and or emotions. Like I stated before, if you're more usually a morning person that likes to just get up in the morning and you are beating your alarm clock, now it's a struggle getting out of the bed. If you're crying and your emotions is out of whack, if you can't identify how you feel and this is happening more often than normal, if you're not excited about the things you used to be excited about, if you love to sing and you haven't had the urge to sing, or if you love to dance and you don't have the energy to dance anymore, those are all things that can contribute to a decline in your mental health. The third thing, be aware of your triggers and learn how to cope more effectively. So you have to know what your triggers are. If your triggers are large crowds of people, you have to be cognizant and use wisdom of some of the places that you may need to go. If you need to go to the grocery store, avoid going on the 1st and the 15th where people usually get, you know, their assistance or they like to, or they get paid. And that's where you'll find the most traffic. Being cognizant of the times that people will go into the grocery store. So maybe just going at night where there's going to be fewer people, or going early in the morning where some people might be at work. Also being able to know when enough is enough, knowing when you need to take a break. Your triggers can also be your children. It can be your job. It can be your spouse. And it's okay to be honest with yourself. If you are feeling overwhelmed, that's a trigger. Anything that is taking you out of the character that you're usually functioning in is a trigger. So we need to be aware of our triggers. We need to learn how to cope. if writing is a thing for you, if singing is a thing for you, is if dancing is a thing for you, is if exercising is a thing for you, if watching your favorite shows, listening to your favorite artists, or listening to something motivational, anything that's saging, anything that's going to get you upbeat, change the shit and shift the energy that's around you, it is very, very, very important that you indulge in your coping skills. Learn your coping skills and indulge in them. It is so good for your mental. 4, knowing when you're overwhelmed. Your body tells you when you're overwhelmed. Your body tells you when it's tired, when it's hungry. Your body will tell you everything. You have to listen to your body. So when you're overwhelmed, it's usually equated to stress. It's equated to fatigue. So listen to your body. When you're overwhelmed, it is okay to take a break. You are never too busy to take a break. 5. Here we go. Know when to take a break. When you take a break, when you need to take a break from people, social media, work, and whatever else that adds to your mental strain, it is okay to take a break. I promise you, if you are prone to doing 1,000 things, it is okay to not do 1,000 things because you are not at the mental capacity to do it. Don't listen to what people say. You are not weak. You are not less than. You are strong to know, hey, I need to take a break. A quick transparent moment, when I was working and I was commuting 1 hour and 40 minutes, at first it was okay, but when the pandemic hit, it just really, really, really showed me how busy I was. And it really, really showed me how I was not taking care of my mental. I was not doing self-care like I should have been. So now that I have had enough courage to resign from that job and to really pour into my gifts. And the Bible says that your gifts will make room for you. Your gifts will bring you wealth. And by the grace of God, it has. So if you have a side hustle, it is okay to indulge in your side hustle and take a break from your real life. Like, do not let fear cripple you. And so the 6th thing is, do not be ashamed to get counseling. A lot of people, especially in the African American community, are so afraid to get counseling. And counseling is so effective, guys. It's so effective. It's so helpful. Getting counseling. Do it. It's very confidential, so the only person that will know is the only people you will tell. So if you go and tell somebody, hey, I'm getting counseling, and they spread it, and they spread it, and they spread it, then that's on you. But it's nothing to be ashamed of. Counseling is the best thing that you can do when you've experienced trauma. You experience regret. You experience neglect. And you've experienced shame and being rejected. Like, anything that you feel like it's overwhelming for you, anything that you have a hard time dealing with, mental health of course, you can get counseling. And it's okay, guys. It is okay to have counseling. It does not mean that you're weak. It does not mean that you are less than. It just means that you are identifying your weaknesses that need to be strengthened. It's perfectly fine to get counseling. I'm a therapist. I recommend it. And the 7th thing, taking one day at a time. You guys, Rome was not built in one day. The earth was not built in one day. You were not built in one day. So allow the process to happen. Fall in love with the process. No matter how hard it is light after every tunnel. You can do it. You can make it. There is nothing impossible with the possible. And you guys, it's nothing wrong with taking a step at a time. Okay? So you guys, that is my topic on mental health awareness. You guys, nowadays, we all need to make sure that we are taking care of ourselves, and so that we can protect ourselves not only from the global pandemic, but definitely taking care of ourselves, that so that when we have a responsibility to take care of others, that we can do it with a pure heart and a pure mind and pure intentions, and that we're not dragging along and existing, and we're actually living. So you guys, that's my topic on mental health awareness. I love you so much. And here comes my favorite part. Don't forget to dream bigger than your fears, more than your imagination, surpassing your wildest dreams. I am Andrea Monroe. Thank you so much for watching Andrea Monroe from head to toe. Okay, I love you guys so much. And the very most important part, don't forget to be amazing. Duh. Bye.